wants me to get like out of his hair. He wants me to find a man, get married. Poor dad.
We're looking for grandchildren, and neither one of you guys are accommodating.
Yeah, what about Hunter? He's 4 years older than me, and he's not with anybody. Work on him.
I'm working on his stuff, too.
But he's not the one who has to get pregnant. He can get somebody else pregnant at a different age.
Now that I'm 30, I'm just feeling like I'm supposed to be at a certain place in life, and I don't feel that I'm there. And I feel jealous and envious of other people who are married and have their own families and careers. But I am concerned that maybe I won't. I started dancing like as soon as I could move. I have memories of being in the car in my seatbelt, and anytime a song would come on, I would just like start gyrating all crazy. And I started in class when I was like 4 years old. And then I started dancing at a performing arts school. And I would split my time between my normal high school and my performing arts school. Starting in college, after I gained a lot of weight, I quit dancing for a period of about 10 years. But now, I may be fat, but I can dance better than most skinny people.
Did you set up Facebook for me?
You sent me a friend request.
Boy, I didn't know it.
Well, I did not make that account for you. Dad made that account. And that's exactly how I met Andrew.
On my account?
On account of me? No, on the internet. That's how I met Andrew.
Oh.
Who I'm going on a date with.
When Whitney says to me, "Mother, I met so-and-so online," I really have no idea what she's talking about, but I just act like I do. In my day, if you were online, then you were in line to get into some club.
Buddy's one of the only straight male friends that I have. He's actually the only straight male friend that I have.
Voila.
What'd you bring me?
Little pep.
I hadn't seen Buddy in almost a decade when all of a sudden one day he delivered pizza to my apartment. And I had the biggest crush. Then, just as I was like getting over Buddy and thinking like, oh, whatever, fine, Buddy. You know, Buddy started to pursue me a little bit. Since when have I ever liked pepperoni? How many times have we eaten pizza together?
We always eat sushi, I don't know.
That's true. And now I think we've finally come to just a standstill where both of us just want to be friends. I have decided that I am ready to start dating again.
Uh-huh.
Don't get jelly. Are you not even jelly?
Not really.
How not?
When have I ever been jelly?
Buddy. This is the thing, Andrew, like, if you decide that you like me, it's like, it's not, like, this is not some weird fetish thing, like, I'm a person, you know? I want to lose probably about 100 pounds, but, like, that would still leave me being fat, so.
There's nothing wrong with being fat.
Just, like, I've started.
If you wanted to get bigger, I'd be okay with that.
No, I'm not getting bigger. Are you okay with that?
Absolutely.
Andrew has questionable intentions.
I like that big, sexy brain of yours.
He's a nice guy, but I don't think it's gonna work out. I think maybe he's not the one for me. I'm 35. I mean, I know you're younger than me, but like, if I'm getting married, having kids and all that, like, I want it to be now.
I don't know if I want kids.
The feeling that it gave me was that he has doubts. Doubts about like the future and like us. I'm scared that Chase is gonna break up with me.
One more step.
I feel so scared.
What are you scared about?
I don't know, I can't.
I'm excited about this.
Okay.
All right, ready?
Yeah.
1, 2, 3. Do you like it?
I've never had rose petals on a bed before. Oh. Oh my God. There's like a table set up with room service with like champagne chilling, and the curtains are drawn and the Eiffel Tower is right there, and there's like rose petals on the bed. Oh my God. There's milk.
There's milk. Well, there's chocolate, so there's gotta be milk.
I know, but nobody ever remembers that I can't have chocolate without milk.
You can't have it?
No.
I know.
I'm really into this.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Good.
No man has
ever done anything like this for me. Not even close. I can't even get a boyfriend to take me out to like fast food.
I did not realize it was this big.
Wow.
Yeah, it looks so small from the balcony.
And we're gonna climb those stairs.
All right.
Oh my gosh.
Wow.
Got us up bright and early for this, huh?
See that elevator coming
down? Look at all those stairs.
It is earlier than the crack of dawn, and we have arrived at the Eiffel Tower for our climb. And this is how many stairs?
It's like 674.
Nope. Ryan came up with this challenge for us to all climb the 674 steps of the Eiffel Tower, and it says on the Eiffel Tower website that it would take a fit person between 35 and 45 minutes to complete it. Ryan thinks that I am fit enough to do it in this amount of time.
She's on the move.
On the move.
All right, we going?
On the move without music.
I told y'all not to wait on me.
Are we going or what?
Ryan, go. I don't want to deal with you.
Okay.
I don't. Are we going or what? Just go.
Keep moving.
I've got my earbuds in, I'm focusing, and my inner, like, personal trainer voice is just like, go, Whitney, just go, go, go. Coming up the rear. Just 50 more steps, and I'm gonna be on the first level. It's so beautiful, and like, we're the only people up there. I mean, who gets the chance, right? To be here on the top of the Eiffel Tower. It's pretty amazing. God, hey, it's beautiful.
Let's take a picture.
Yeah.
Let's get you for.
Oh, like from the vine?
Yeah.
That's my signature shot.
Yeah, I'm gonna take a picture of you.
Make sure you get the full, like.
Everything and all of Paris.
Okay.
Hold on,
let me stop blowing everywhere. Okay, is that good?
Yeah, take a look at it.
I'm like.
Whitney Thor, will you marry me?
What? Oh. My God.
Is that a,
Yes. Yes! Oh my God. I'm not even processing what is going on. I just climbed like 600 stairs. I'm sweaty and I'm also freezing.
Right now, I'm just head over heels in love with Whitney. Everything is perfect right now.